Snake, do you remember the sinking of that tanker 2 years ago?
Of course.
Terrorists blow a hole in an oil tanker full of crude barely 20 miles off the shore of Manhattan. Your classic nightmare. It didn't take long for the government to put an oil fence around the whole mess. And then that massive offshore cleanup facility went up inside.
The big shell. I hear the cleanup isn't quite over yet.
It takes time. But in the meantime, the shell's become a landmark, a symbol of environmental protection.
Calling teams Alpha and Bravo. Deploy at the big shell as scheduled.
Approximately 6 hours ago, the big shell was seized by an armed group.
Do we have an ID?
Former members of the Navy SEALs Special Anti-Terrorist Training Squad Dead Cell. Russian private army members may also be involved. It's a highly trained group, and they have the big shell under complete control. $30 billion.
$30 billion? What makes them think they can get that much?
There was a government-sponsored tour going on at the Big Shell that day.
Hostages, huh?
A VIP from one of the major conservation groups, and one from our own government. The most important person, in a sense.
The most important person?
James Johnson.
The president?
Unless the demands are met, the terrorists intend to blow the Big Shell out of the water.
And the crude will ignite, turning the Manhattan Harbor into an inferno.
That's not the worst-case scenario. If the chlorides being used to decontaminate the seawater go up with the oil, toxins containing catastrophic levels of dioxins will be released. In other words, the bay's ecosystem will be wiped out, and the sea will turn into a toxic soup for centuries, becoming the worst environmental disaster in history. You have two mission objectives. One, infiltrate the offshore decontamination facility Big Shell and safeguard the president and other hostages. And two, disarm the terrorists by any means necessary. You should know that SEAL Team 10 is also conducting a rescue operation.
Is this a joint effort?
No. Foxhound remains a covert body. Don't alert them to your presence. That is an order.
This is Snake. I'm now inside Strut A of Shell 1.
How are things?
We're in luck. Looks like there are no sentries posted here.
What's the visibility?
The lights on the plant's struts are functioning. I won't have to use the IR goggles.
Any problems?
There was a brand new hole cut through the oil fence. There's someone else besides me that wanted to get in badly.
That's not possible.
What about SEAL Team 10?
They landed on the roof of the Big Shell as planned. And by the way, Snake, we're changing your code name for all following communication.
What's wrong with Snake?
Just a precaution. You are now designated Raiden. All right, Raiden. You've already covered infiltration and VR training.
I've completed 300 missions in VR. I feel like some kind of legendary mercenary.
Okay, we'll skip that part. Make sure nobody sees you. If you need to, contact me by codec. The frequency is 140.85. When you want to use the codec, push the select button. When we need to reach you, contact you, the codec will beep. When you hear that noise, press the select button. The codec's receiver directly stimulates the small bones of your ear. No one but you will be able to hear it.
All right. I'll contact you if anything changes.
First, make your way to the upper section of the Big Shell.
How do I get up to the next level?
There's an elevator at the far end of that area. Use that.
Sounds good.
Your new sneaking suit uses electrofiber technology, a byproduct of fiber optics research. The texture isn't far removed from rubber, but the material protects against a wide range of toxic substances. The suit itself has a wide array of built-in sensors. It is referred to as smart skin in military R&D. Data about damage to different regions of the body, including blood loss, is exchanged between the suit and the intravenous nanomachines to create a feedback system.
There's a lot of pressure on my torso.
Relax. The suit applies varying pressure to major internal organs to maximize performance and safeguard their functions. They call this the skull suit in Foxhound.
Skull suit seems appropriate somehow.
The hatch with a circular handle will open into the elevator area. Locate the hatch first.
Copy that. Moving on to main mission objectives.
Got your feet wet? These are the basic controls for swimming. When you're on the surface, you can swim in corresponding directions using the up, down, left, and right movement of the left analog stick. Push the punch button to dive down from the surface. Stroke the water and move forward by pushing the punch button. Push it in rapid succession to swim faster. Change your heading with the left analog stick. Up will take you up, down takes you lower, left and right to face those directions. The O2 gauge will appear under your life gauge while you're underwater. The gauge corresponds to the amount of air you can hold from a single deep breath. Once the O2 gauge falls to zero, the life gauge will start to drop. You need to be aware of that.
Colonel, I've sighted an enemy sentry. AN-94 and a Makarov. Those grenades, all his equipment, is Russian-made.
Must be a Gerlukovich man.
Gerlukovich?
A Russian private army that was in line to work with the Shadow Moses takeover group 4 years ago.
What's their stake in this one?
They must have made a deal, an arrangement with the terrorists. They've become a band of mercenaries, an army without a country.
Colonel, there's definitely another intruder in here besides me.
That's not a possibility.
Not a team. Looks like a solo job.
One man.
We may not know who he is, but he managed to take care of every sentry in the area. They're all out cold. Whoever he is, he's got some skills.
We need to get an ID. But for now, you can take advantage of the situation and get to work. There's a terminal in front of the elevator. A node.
Did you say nerd?
Not nerd. Node.
Oh.
Use the node to gain access to the Big Shell's facilities network.
Then what?
Pull up the map of the structure. That'll let you activate the Soliton radar.
The Soliton radar? True. That radar came in useful during VR training.
A radar system uses biological magnetic fields as input. These estimated enemy positions are projected onto a map according to reference points collected via GPS signals and field personnel reports. We need to get to the map through the Big Shell's node to put this data processing to practical use. The node unit is about 3 feet high, should be colored blue. Each area has at least one.
How do I gain access?
Just push the action button in front of the node. The nanomachines in your body will take care of the security clearance and allow you access to the node. Complete the procedure before those sentries gain consciousness. If they spot you, you won't be able to gain access for a while. Stay on guard.
Got it.
Raiden, you won't be able to use any of the enemy's equipment.
Why not?
You should know that all active weapons are equipped with a personal identification system. The owner enters their required user ID information during the weapon registration or at the start of a mission. If anyone other than the registered user tries to fire the weapon, the ID system will not authorize the action.
But these are black market Russian weapons. How can they be equipped with identification functionality?
They must have been customized by the terrorists themselves. These are professionals we're dealing with, and they certainly won't let their own equipment be used against them.
I'm guessing it's the same for the Navy SEALs gear?
Right.
How am I supposed to procure weapons then?
Find the ones that haven't yet been individualized. Everything you find in the item box is clean. You should know this from your VR training.
Okay, I know those.
Items in the item box are yours to use at will. They will be your supply source with regards to weaponry and gear.
Good work, Raiden.
The radar should be functioning now?
Remember your VR training sessions. The tool is exactly the same one. It maps the terrain as well as the position of enemy personnel. The bright dot in the middle is you, Raiden. The red dots are your enemies, and the blue cone shape represents their field of vision. Your radar isn't affected by the weather, but if you're discovered by an enemy, you won't be able to use it. It gets jammed easily, I'm afraid. It's all made from currently existing technology. You won't be able to use it in an area with strong harmonic resonance, so be careful. The Big Shell's layout map should now be available after touching the start button.
How do I save the mission data?
I've set aside a proprietary frequency for saves, and an analyst to work on the data too.
Jack, is everything all right?
What are you doing here?
Jack, can you hear me?
Rose, you're not supposed to be involved. What's going on?
Jack, I'm a part of this mission.
Colonel, what the hell is going on?
Raiden, meet the mission analyst. She'll be overseeing the data saving and support.
Why her?
The Foxhound analyst that was supposed to take part in this mission was in an accident. Rosemary was brought in as a replacement.
An accident?
And according to the files, she knows you better than anybody else.
Rose may be in the service, but an intelligence analyst is no field officer.
Not to worry. She has our technical staff at her disposal.
She's never been a part of a field mission. This is insane.
I have my own reasons for selecting her for this mission, soldier.
Colonel, I fail to see...
I know your VR training performance in and out, but sometimes that's not enough. You're familiar with the Shadow Moses incident?
You know I covered it in VR.
If there's a crucial tactical detail that case taught us, it was the power of the operative's will to survive.
I was trained to fight. My personal feelings have no place in a mission.
We've learned that it doesn't work that way. And on the field, you need all the help you can get.
Jack, you're stuck with me whether you like it or not.
Rose.
You need someone to watch your back. But I have conditions that need to be met, Colonel.
What is it?
I'll perform my duties and save that mission data, but I'm aware that technically I'm not part of the mission control team. After all, I'm just a normal girl who's worried about Jack. But that means, Colonel, that I am not required to follow your orders outside of my immediate duties. Jack is not simply a field personnel for me to track. His safety comes first to me, not the mission. And because of that, I will be monitoring and keeping a record of every communication you have with him, Colonel.
Given the circumstances, you're free to do what you see fit.
Hey, I prefer this to being kept in the dark waiting.
I'd like to make a request, if I may.
Of course.
His handle is Raiden. For the duration of the mission, could you call him that?
Yes, sir. All right, Raiden. Let me know when you're ready to turn in a save. The proprietary save frequency is 140.96. I just switched frequencies. Jack?
What?
Do you know what day it is tomorrow?
April 30th. Is there something special about it?
Isn't there?
I can't remember. I'm sorry.
Oh, well. I'll keep trying till I hear the answer. I'm gonna let you go now, Jack. Take care.
Raiden, the enemy sentry is regaining consciousness.
Be careful, Jack.
Find somewhere to hide until the elevator arrives. You must stay out of sight.
Enemy sighted. Requesting backup unit.
What's wrong? Raiden! Raiden!
I'm under enemy fire. Secure the perimeter.
Stay on lookout.
I need help. Under enemy fire! Secure the perimeter!
Stay on lookout!
Terrorists call themselves Sons of Liberty.
Sons of Liberty?
The name of their leader is Solid Snake.
The hero of Shadow Moses? So that's why he changed my code name.
Right, but he can't be the Solid Snake. He died 2 years ago on that tanker after he blew it sky high.
Could he have survived?
Not a chance.
Colonel, I'm on the roof. There are no sentries, but it would only take one to spot me in this light.
You never had daylight VR training after all. Stay extra sharp until you can find a node to log in from.
What about the commandos?
SEAL Team 10 has landed on struts B and C.
And the President?
Seems he was spotted on Strut B.
Strut B?
The Big Shell is comprised of shells 1 and 2. Each unit consists of a central core and 6 struts surrounding it.
So the whole thing is shaped like 2 hexagons connected end on end.
Exactly. And you're on the roof of Strut A, Shell 1 at the moment. First, get to a node. Log into the network.
Got it.
Thank you.
Raiden, the elevator's gone down. There's no need for you to return to the deep sea dock. Proceed with the mission. If you see an approximately waist-high railing, push... Right, come in. Right. Right. Raiden, look at that wire fence. You may be able to crawl through it. Crouch down using the crawl button, then push the left analog stick in the direction you want to move. Push the crawl button again to stand up. You can use weapons even while crawling. This is different from VR training, so you keep that in mind.
Raiden, SEAL Team 10 is in.
Do we really have no line of communication with the SEALs?
They don't know a thing about us. You know we work in the dark, and this mission is no exception. Only a few people know about your presence here. There's no need for concern. This operation is under Pentagon's direct command, and the NSDD came from the Vice President and the Secretary of Defense. Your mission may be top secret, but it's gone through the usual channels.
I'll go check the roof. I'll leave the first floor to you, okay?
Understood.
Colonel, I've located the node, but it's under heavy surveillance. I can't get in any closer.
Distract them. Try making some noise to draw their attention away.
How?
Flatten yourself against a wall and hit the punch button.
Got it.
Raiden, watch your back. That's a cipher, a type of UAV. If it spots you, it will alert enemy personnel. Exercise extreme caution. But you can use chaff to set up an interference field. That'll knock its sensors offline for a while. Try to locate some chaff. You can also destroy the engine or the camera. Some of the UAVs may be armed. Be careful.
Copy that.
Wait a second. I just intercepted new intelligence on the operation being executed by SEAL Team 10.
Intercepted?
As I said before, they need to be kept in the dark about our presence.
So we just listen in?
I'm patching it through.
This is Alpha Zero. We have the President.
Is he safe?
He is safe.
What about the package?
Tell the guys upstairs that we've secured the package. Easy money.
Good work. Your retrieval is on the way. Come on home.
Roger that.
Holy!
Alpha Zero, report.
Damn it, cover the President!
Come in, Alpha Zero.
This is Alpha Zero. We're under attack. This is crazy! Is that...
Alpha Zero, respond. All Alpha, respond.
Raiden, the President's life is in danger. Head to Strut B now.
Thank you.
enemy. I need that.
Communications with Strut F have ceased. Carry out an investigation immediately.
Enemy. I need help. Thank you.
This isn't happening. Jack, you have to answer me. Jack! Jack!
Here.
Ha!
Is everything all right? Right?
Right, Anne!
Raiden, didn't you hear what the SEAL said? The President is in trouble. Head for Strut B. Strut B is to the northwest of Strut A. First, make your way to Strut A on the double. The President's life is at stake here. Raiden! You're currently using artificial blood primed with nanomachines.
What did you do with my own blood?
It's being kept in cold storage. It will be circulated back into your body when you return. If the life gauge drops to the red zone, you won't be able to stop the bleeding by yourself. Bloodstains can give your presence away to the enemy. Be careful. To stop the flow, select a bandage from among your items. You can also go into a crouch or crawl and stay completely still for a while. All you have to do is stop moving for a duration of time, and your nanomachines will arrange for platelets to be produced in large numbers. The bleeding will stop as a result.
Thank you. survive today. Or rather, six.
Get down! Where is he?
Strange smell. You smell like... Are you?
It has to be. Shoot him! What are you waiting for?
Vamp.
Yeah, Queen?
Are you all done cleaning up?
Yes, but wait till I tell you what I found.
Something interesting?
I'll tell you in person. Where are you?
In the central unit with the president.
Be right there.
Hold on. I'm not an enemy. Calm down. My name is Plissken. Iroquois Plissken. Lieutenant Junior Grade.
Are you a Navy SEAL? How did you get in?
Fast rope descent from a Navy chopper.
Have I seen you before?
That suit. Are you Foxhound?
That's right.
Foxhound was disbanded.
Huh?
Where were you before Foxhound? Delta Force?
I was part of the Army's Force 21 trials.
Force 21? That's about tactical IT deployment, right? Any field experience?
No, not really.
So this is your first?
I've had extensive training, the kind that's indistinguishable from the real thing.
Like what?
Sneaking mission 60, weapons 80, advanced...
VR, huh?
But realistic in every way.
A virtual grunt of the digital age, that's just great.
That's far more effective than live exercises.
You don't get injured in VR, do you? Every year, a few soldiers die in field exercises.
There's pain sensation in VR, and even a sense of reality and urgency. The only difference is it isn't actually happening.
That's the way they want you to think, to remove you from the fear that goes with battle situations. War is a video game. What better way to raise the ultimate soldier?
So you're saying that VR training is some kind of mind control?
Raiden, what's going on?
The Alpha team from Navy SEAL 10 is dead. No, a single survivor.
The kid's wired with nanomachines.
What about the president?
Looks like they took him somewhere else.
I see. You said there was a survivor from SEAL Team 10.
Yeah. Lieutenant J.G. Plissken.
Has he seen your face?
What?
This is a top secret mission. No one can know that we're involved.
It's a little too late for that. What's up?
Take a look.
What the hell?
A Navy captain.
You all right?
Give me a few minutes. Must have lost a few more pints than I thought.
What was that man just now?
That blood-sucking freak? That was Vamp. He's Romanian, a wizard with knives, as you saw.
The way he moved didn't seem human.
You won't see that in VR, I guarantee.
What is he?
One of the members of Dead Cell.
Dead Cell? Him?
A special forces unit created by ex-president George Sears. The name was originally intended to reflect its anti-terrorist functions. The unit would launch unannounced assaults on government complexes for the ultimate terrorism simulation. They were needed to show VR troopers like you how to deal with the real thing. But around the time their original leader died in prison, the unit began to unravel. They were always close to the edge, but they became more and more extreme, began to go after U.S. allies, even civilians. We estimate that no fewer than 100 people died as a result of accidents the Dead Cell arranged on their own. They were out of control, and it all came to a head 6 months ago.
What happened?
The unit was devastated. There are only 3 left now, and you just saw one of them.
Why would they go after the Big Shell?
How should I know? I told you they were on the lunatic fringe.
What about their leader? He says he's Solid Snake.
Snake died 2 years ago.
You mean the incident that made this Big Shell necessary in the first place?
Right, and he was the one that sank that tanker.
But he's a legend.
Legends are usually bad news. There's not a lot of difference between heroes and madmen.
You're saying Snake is still alive and pulled another one?
No, he's not involved in this one. His body was positively ID'd 2 years ago.
Snake is dead.
And buried.
What about the other soldiers? I saw Russian equipment, too.
Former Soviet military. They're probably mercenaries. The Big Shell is too much ground for just Dead Cell members to hold down. You weren't briefed on any of this? And you came in alone to boot? Why? What are you really doing here? Can't tell me, huh? Fine with me.
I don't smoke.
Keep it anyway. May come in handy. Take this, too.
Come in, Alpha Zero. This is Bravo Zero, currently at the bridge between struts B and C. The president is... Damn, I can't hit this thing. It's like some bad dream. Alpha, anyone, come in, all Alpha. This is Bravo Zero.
Aren't you going to answer him?
BC connecting bridge.
We need to get there. Can you handle it?
I need a few more minutes. Remember my frequency. It's 141.80.
141.80. Got it.
I've been briefed on this plant's layout. If you need information on the place or about Dead Cell, contact me. You're using nano communication, right?
Yeah, but I can patch into your frequency.
Hey, what's your name?
Raiden.
Raiden? Strange code name.
Makes up for the boring one my parents gave me.
Maybe I'll find out someday.
Raiden, forget about that guy.
I think you should just let him sleep.
Return to your duties. Head for the BC connecting bridge. Be quick about it.
Jack, it's me.
Everything okay, Rose?
Don't you need to save the mission data?
Oh yeah, thanks for the reminder.
Jack, do you remember what day tomorrow is?
That again. I'm sorry, but I still don't have a clue.
That's okay.
What is it, Rose? Talk to me.
I'd rather you figure it out. It's important.
How important?
Important enough. And we'll talk about it tomorrow.
Why not now?
Tomorrow seems more appropriate. I need all the help I can get so that I won't chicken out anyway.
Is that the reason you decided to be part of this mission? Okay. I'm gonna finish this thing by tomorrow, no matter what.
You know I'll do everything I can to help you.
Rose, there's something I need you to do as an analyst.
What is it?
It has to do with Solid Snake. The leader of this takeover incident is claiming that he's Snake himself.
The legendary mercenary?
I need as much data on him as possible. Everything they have on him after the Shadow Moses incident.
He's dead now, isn't he?
Yes. Should be a burial record somewhere, too. You should be able to request top-level security clearance from the Colonel. That should get us into the most classified material.
I'm on it. I'll contact you as soon as I find out something.
Put me out of my misery.
This is impossible. Nothing will hit her.
Is she the one they call Fortune?
Today is another bad day. Is there anyone here that can give me happiness?
I'm so sorry, my beauties. I'll see you again someday.
Colonel, SEAL Team 10's Bravo team was wiped out.
I see.
What happened to the cargo choppers?
Both of them are at the bottom of the harbor. Looks like your new hosts have a Harrier, too.
A Harrier? What is this?
Calm down. It just means they anticipated the attack.
What?
Besides, since the SEALs drew their fire, your infiltration went off without a hitch. On top of that, we know their defensive capabilities.
Are you saying this was all a feint?
Raiden, get a hold of yourself. The entire mission is in your hands now. Do you understand?
But...
There's no time for questions. They could decide to retaliate for that failed assault.
You mean the hostages?
They could be in danger, yes. But we need to consider the possibility that they'll blow the whole shell. If that toxic spell does take place, it'll devastate not only the harbor, but poison the coastline for generations. Raiden, we've had to adjust the mission objectives. The priority is now on removing those C4s at the terrace wired over the big shell. The president can wait, but this can't.
Colonel, you know I'm no bomb disposal expert.
That's not a problem. The Bravo team brought an explosives pro in with them. He was supposed to stand by on Strut C according to their mission plan. You should find him there.
Is this according to simulation too?
What are you talking about? Get to Strut C and find him.
Understood. But I need to ask you something before I go.
Make it quick.
Who are they? Dead Cell, I mean. They couldn't hit her no matter how hard they tried. And that vampire, too, it's like being in a nightmare you can't wake up from.
Jack, snap out of it.
And you, Rose, I can't believe you're on this mission. I keep thinking I'll wake up.
Raiden, this is real. And that's why you won't wake up.
But nothing seems real.
I've made up my mind to stay with you. Whether this is real or a bad dream, I'll keep watching you till it's over.
Thank you, Rose. And I won't let you be just a dream.
Are you two done? Raiden, you're needed on Strut C. Raiden, what are you doing there? With that?
I don't believe it. What are you thinking? Enduring your duties?
I highly disapprove.
Even though every one of us is scrambling to do our best to support you, this? And what exactly are you going to do? Drool over pictures of voluptuous girls?
Exactly.
At least use a picture of me instead.
Why?
I mean...
I completely disapprove. It's possible the terrorist...
freeze!
Don't shoot.
You a cop?
I'm not NYPD. I came in with the Bravo team. Who are you with, and what happened to SEAL Team 10?
They're all dead.
All of them? That's bad.
Did I tell you you could move?
It's all right. He's not one of the bad guys. Don't go pointing that thing everywhere, kid. What's your name?
My name is Peter. Peter Stillman.
I'm a lecturer at Navscolio at Indian Head, also a consultant for the NYPD bomb squad.
A poor old man who got dragged along for this picnic.
I thought you'd retired.
I did. Can't keep up with everybody, as you can see. A famous church got wiped off the map thanks to me, with too many lives inside. All I lost was this leg.
So you're the bomb disposal guy.
Kid, this is the bomb disposal guy. Open any explosives disposal textbook and you'll see his name.
Just ancient history now.
Why did they bring you out of retirement then?
Because the terrorist group here includes one of my students, the Emperor of Explosives, Fat Man. He built an atomic bomb when he was only 10. I created him in a sense.
And that's why you're here.
I'm pretty rusty. I was supposed to supervise the bomb disposal. Looks like it was taken care of before I had my turn.
I wouldn't say that. There are at least two people here who can claim to be experts at bomb disposal.
Are you two with SEAL Team 10? I didn't see you at the mission briefing.
Oh, we're with another squad. My name is Pliskin, Lieutenant Junior Grade. Honored to meet you, sir.
Mr. Pliskin, do you have any experience with explosives disposal?
Don't worry about me. And he looks young, but he can do it. But we need more manpower.
What's your name?
Raiden.
That's an odd name.
Any other survivors?
There was also an engineer with me.
An engineer?
A skinny guy. He went in with us.
Where is he?
I haven't seen him since that skirmish.
Was he killed?
I don't think so. I didn't find his body.
I see.
They told me he was a security systems architect for the Big Shell.
Why would they take a civilian along?
Everything in this structure is computer controlled. He was supposed to get us past all the security measures.
I never heard anything about that.
He had official orders with him.
We'll leave that for later. Right now, we need to figure out how to deal with all the bombs.
But there's no one left from the SEAL's EOD squad.
Yep, so we have to do it ourselves.
But I've never defused a bomb before. Hold on a sec.
Off to confer with the CO again.
Glad to hear Stillman is safe. Assist him in any way possible to clear the C4 from the structure.
Colonel, you know I've never been trained in bomb disposal.
It's all right. The man you're working with is the best in the field. All you have to do is follow his directions. You will, of course, keep your identity and mission objectives to yourself.
Is it true that an engineer came in with Stillman?
I wasn't informed of that. It's probably something the SEALs decided on their own. There are more important issues at hand, Raiden. The enemy may retaliate for the failed assault. Get those C4s neutralized now.
Colonel, I'm not qualified for bomb disposal.
Jack, it's me.
Rose?
You can do this. Trust me.
You haven't had bomb disposal training per se in VR, but you're more than capable of handling C4.
This is a little different from using C4.
You're up for this. You know that.
How about it, kid? Are the results in yet?
There's no need to think about this so much. You won't actually be dismantling the bomb. That's not for amateurs. What we'll try here instead is a temporary freezing measure. Here, look at this. This is a C4 bomb. It's live. You can see it pulsing. Now you spray this on the sucker, and there we go. Simple, huh? The spray freezes the detonator instantly.
How long does the effect last?
There's no way the thing can detonate in this condition. Even if you leave it alone, it'll stay out of commission for at least 24 hours.
That's enough time.
If we had the manpower, I'd recommend complete disposal. But this will have to do. The spray can be used from several yards away. Now check the floor, ceiling, walls, under a table, everywhere. Try to imagine the locations the bomber would choose.
That won't be easy. We don't know a thing about Fat Man.
Is there anything that'll help us locate the bombs?
Here, take this with you. It's what they call an ion mobility spectrometer. It can recognize ionized gas emitted by C4s.
The what?
In other words, that little gadget sniffs out C4's scent.
That's right. I've established a link-up with your radar network, so any scent detected will be represented visually. Have the sensor activated and keep your eye on the radar.
What if he's using some other odorless substance?
I know Fat Man well. I know how into his own aesthetics he is.
Signatures?
Yes. On every bomb he builds, he always leaves a trace of the cologne he uses. The sensor also picks up that particular scent spectrum.
Is that something he learned from you?
No, it was his own quirk. He wouldn't work by any rules except his own, and he followed them like a religion. And common sense wasn't one of his strong points. I thought I taught him everything I knew. I have no children of my own, and I thought I found a son in him. He had the right stuff, you know. There's something very unusual about an ability like that. Even at Indian Head, he got special treatment. I remember some people called him one of the fat cats. Maybe that's what started all this. I didn't teach him the most important thing I had to tell him. There are some things you have to pass on. The trick is to know which one. Right. All I taught him was skills. And now I have to stop him from using it to destroy us all.
Let's see how well that sensor works.
All right. I'm activating him. Watch. You see the green stuff on the radar? That's a visual representation of the C4 scent detected by the sensor.
It's a pretty big area, isn't it?
Don't complain. It's better than nothing.
Just activate the sensors and search the area, okay?
All right.
Don't forget that you need the radar to use this system. Log into the node at every strut and turn the radar on.
We have to keep out of the enemy's sight, too.
Because the radar gets knocked offline when we're spotted?
Exactly. Fat Man would have allotted some C4s here in Strut C as well.
Here?
I know the structure of this facility, and if he wants to take out the plant, where he would target.
You know this for sure?
Of course. I taught him the techniques he uses. His ideas are based on my theories. Demolition is a kind of ideology. It makes no exceptions for time or place. Big Shell consists of two hexagons joined end on end, north to south. There should be packets of C4s on each of the vertices, or the struts in this case. You need at least that to take a building of this integrity out.
Six on shell one, another six on shell two. A total of 12 bombs at least.
Considering the shell's architecture and composition from an engineering standpoint, that's my conclusion, and it's exactly what he would have decided as well.
Kid, this place is all yours. I'll take care of Shell 2.
Take this.
What's this?
Security card issued to Shell personnel. The Big Shell security layout includes varying levels of clearance. The clearance level is identified by the number printed on these doors. Raiden, your card key can open doors with security clearance level 1. Plissken, your card can get you into level 3 areas. You'll need it to get next door to Shell 2.
How did you get this?
That engineer I told you about gave it to me. He was supposed to program a set of all access cards once we were on site. Unfortunately, this card won't get you into every area of this structure.
We'll have to deal with the remaining security lockouts as they come up. Let's get going. You stay here.
No, I'm going.
The two of us can handle it, don't worry.
But...
You'll just slow us down with that leg of yours. There's a war going on here. I don't have time to babysit anymore.
Why don't you just let us handle the grunt work? You can tell us what to do over the radio, like in the original mission plan.
All right. I'll give you instructions from here. I may also need to prepare a backup plan, just in case.
In case of what?
Good luck to both of you. This is a dangerous one.
Who dares, wins.
If anything comes up, let me know. My frequency is 140.25.
Good luck, kid. I'll see you later. Semper Fi.
That man's no SEAL. I don't even think he's a Navy man.
What?
Semper Fi. Marine Corps talk. Normally, team leaders stay in the CP and give orders with those headphones. And as far as I know, SEALs keep their officers away from the field. And Who Dares Wins is a model of the British Special Air Service.
Is he one of the terrorists, then?
No, somehow I don't think so. If there's someone to suspect, I'd put my money on you.
I'm...
Just take care of those bombs for now.
What about you? They could be back in this area soon.
I'll hide out in this pantry for a while. If I lock the door, it should be all right. Plenty of food in here, too, so you don't need to worry about me. I'll give you instructions by codec from here. Good luck, kid. Bomb disposal is a face-off with your own mortality. Don't let the fear get to you. When you give in to the fear, the darkness comes.
Raiden here. I took care of the C4 in Strut C. The ceiling of the women's bathroom was set to blow.
That's not like him.
Anything wrong?
Maybe. Pliskin's reported other locations too, and none of them are effective demolition points.
What do you mean?
It means that they wouldn't be the best places to choose if you wanted to destroy this place.
Are you saying they don't plan on blowing the shell up?
It certainly seems that way. So far we haven't seen anything but a waste of good explosives. Unless, of course, we're missing something.
A trap?
He couldn't have overlooked the fact that I would be called into this. There's something going on.
Raiden. Stillman is a top-notch explosives technician. Follow his orders and disarm the explosives.
Okay, but exactly who is Peter Stillman?
Gotcha. I'll look him up. Hold on a moment. What's up, Jack? Jack, it must be so nerve-wracking to defuse a bomb.
Yeah, I'd say so.
Okay, that was a stupid thing to say. Sorry.
That's all right. It's just that I've never been trained in this stuff.
You okay? Are you feeling well?
I almost threw up a few times.
Oh, Jack.
But I'm okay. It's not like I'm in this alone.
Oh, yeah, that's true. What do you think about when you're defusing those things?
I don't think so much as remember. And I know that I need to resist that and keep my mind blank. I can't let myself be overwhelmed by the fear.
So, am I a part of what you try not to remember? I was just kidding, but I guess this isn't a good time for that.
No, it is. And I do think about you. I'm trying to remember what's so special about April 30th.
Any success?
No, not yet.
You need to stay alive so you can.
Okay, that's a deal.